blue oil system of HHP locomotive. Blue oil subsystem of HHP locomotive. The complete engine lubricating oil system of HHP locomotive is combination of four subsystems. These are scavenging oil system, main lubricating oil system, piston cooling system, and shockback system. For all these systems, there is a separate own lube oil pump. So let us understand all these subsystems separately first. A scavenging oil system. To understand a scavenging oil system, we have to know about the engine components involved in this system. The engine components may be seen clearly in the slides. Now let us discuss on various components one by one in different slides. Strainer assembly. Strainer assembly is having aluminium casted outer body. It has two compartments. In one compartment, there is only one strainer, and this compartment is connected to suction side of a scavenging pump. Another compartment is having two fine strainer, and this compartment is at suction side of main lube oil pump. Scavenging lube oil pump. Scavenging lube oil pump is positive displacement helical gear type pump. It is driven by accessories drive gear, and its discharge pressure is 20 to 35 psi. Its discharge capacity is 405 gallon per minute at 900 rpm. Lube oil filter tank. Lube oil filter tank is mounted on equipment rack and located in accessories compartment. It is having 5 paper type filter elements which needs to be replaced after every 90 days. A filter conditions gauge is also provided across filter tank. If gauge needle shows yellow and red zone, the lube oil filter needs change. Lube oil cooler. Conventional type lube oil cooler is fitted in HHP locomotive and it is located in accessories compartment on equipment rack. The overhauling of lube oil cooler is to be carried out after 1 year. The coolant and the oil flow through the cooler in opposite directions to produce the maximum cooling effect. Scavenging oil system. A scavenging oil system of HHP loco can be easily understood here in this slide. When engine starts, the scavenging pump takes lube oil from oil sump tanks through coarse maize compartment of strainer assembly. Here we have to keep in mind that there are two compartments in strainer assembly. Now the scavenging pump feeds lube oil to lube oil filter tank, which is located in accessories compartment. After filtrations, lube oil from filter tank goes to lube oil cooler, where it is cooled by engine cooling water to regain its viscosity. From lube oil cooler, lube oil comes to fine strainer compartment of strainer assembly, where it is filtered once again. Now filtered lube oil ready to supply in engine. Up to here, the system is called scavenging oil system. In this slide, we can understand the main lube oil pump takes lube oil from fine strainer compartment of strainer assembly and supply to main lube oil manifold by discharging at a port. Main lube oil pump is helical gear type pump. Its discharge pressure at 8 notch is 100 to 120 psi. This pump is driven by crankshaft of main engine. Through this slide, I want to clarify that the main lube oil pump discharges lube oil at this indicated point, and this is connected to main oil folder. In this slide, I want to show you the main oil folder's location, which is just above the crankshaft. Through this slide, I want to explain how crankshaft main bearing receives lube oil from main lube oil manifold through a copper pipe. In HHP locomotives, there are total 10 crankshaft main bearings, and all main bearings get lubricated in the same pattern with the help of copper pipe connection. In this slide, main lubricating oil system can be easily understood. The yellow line indicates the flow of lubricating oil discharged from the main lube oil pump. First, the main lube oil pump takes lube oil from strainer assembly through a common suction. Further, lube oil goes to the main lube oil manifold. From there, lube oil goes to all crankshaft main bearing. Drilled passage in the crankshaft supplies oil to the connecting rod bearings, vibration damper, and accessories drive gear at front end of the crankshaft. At rear end, camshaft, stub shaft, Adler gear number 1 and 2, and turbo supercharger gear train also get lubricated. An oil line from each camshaft bearings at each cylinder supplies oil to the rocker arm shaft, rocker arm cam follower assemblies, hydraulic lash adjuster, and to rocker arm. Finally, liquid oil returned to the shunt tank. In this slide, we can easily understand the main lube oil pump and piston cooling pump are contained in one housing and mounted in the center of accessories drive housing. Both lube oil pump are receives oil from strainer assembly through common suction pipe. Through this slide, I want to make you understand the location of lube oil discharge by piston cooling pump. Piston cooling oil system. In this slide, we can understand how underside of piston crown is being cooled by lubricating oil. Yellow color indicates presence of lubricating oil. Piston pin bearings is also lubricated here. Piston cooling system. In piston cooling system, piston cooling lube oil pump receives oil from strainer assembly through common suction pipe and delivers oil to the two piston cooling oil manifold extending the full length of the engine, one on each bank. A P-pipe or piston cooling pipe at each cylinder liner directs a stream of oil to cool the underside of the piston crown. This stream of oil also lubricates the ring belt. Some of this oil enters oil grooves in the piston pin bearings for lubrication. Oil after cooling and lubrications drains back into the oil sump. Soak back system of HHP locomotive. In HHP locomotive, a separate lube oil system is provided for turbo supercharger. This system is called soak back system. The main purpose of this system is to ensure the lubrication of the turbo supercharger bearings prior to engine start. This system also removes heats from the turbo bearings after engine shutdown. This system is controlled automatically by the locomotive control system. Soak back oil system. The component involved in soak back oil system can be seen in this slide. These all components are located at right side of the main engine. Soak back system layout. In soak back system, a electrically operated turbo soak back pump draw oil from the oil sump and feed to turbo bearings. This soak back pump automatically start working before cranking of the engine. When engine start, the main low oil pump pressure become greater than the soak back pump pressure. This time, the relief valve provided in the soak back filter head, which is set to 32 psi, will return the low oil back to engine shaft. After shutting down of the main engine, this soak back pump start working automatically and supply oil to turbo bearings and save from thermal stressing. Layout, complete engine low oil system. In this slide, layout of complete low oil system of HHP locomotive is shown, and it may understand also. This is the combination of all four subsystems which are explained in previous slides. Hot oil detector. Hot oil detector is an engine safety device located on the outlet elbow of the main low oil pump. When oil temperature rises to 124 degrees centigrade, the thermostatic valve will open and oil is allowed to drain into some tank. This results low low oil pressure and engine shutdown. Low oil consumption. The points enlisted in this slides may be the reasons of excessive low oil consumption in HHP locomotives. Thanks to all for watching and listening this videos.